Right, so are you guys ready? Take it away.
So, hi, I'm Amita. I'm a multimedia writer for the last 4 years now. I'm a quality engineer at Red Hat. And my basic job is like testing director services at Red Hat. But this is something of my interest. I test open source, mainly Fedora, in my free time. So, how many of you are developers? Okay. Any of you test sometime? Do things?
Production.
Okay. And so far, how you are liking the process? Post issue? Talks and presentations? Enjoy the conference? Okay. So, the takeaway from my presentation will be that at least, even if you are a tester, if you are a user, or you are a programmer, testing should be part of everybody's job. It can be done by everyone. So, by saying that, I'd like to start with my agenda, which will cover how you can contribute in improving the quality of the product you are using. Any operating system you are using, any application you are using, how you can contribute in improving the quality of that test. And then, why to create a test harness for your application, how to alter your software development that will focus on the developer side or the coding part, how you can alter your techniques so that you can make your product less bug prone. Okay, and then we can talk about the bug reporting, how you can triage the bug, how can you find the bugs, and how should you report the bugs. And at last, the troubleshooting part. Okay, so this is the question from many people that I don't know the programming, I'm just a user. How can I contribute in open source projects? So there are many ways, like designing or spreading it around the world as a user you are using, but the definite good way when you are not a programmer and you want to learn something about the product, then the answer is testing, which is the best thing and easiest thing you can do. So testing is the best way to start with. I would like to ask you people why the testing is the best way. If you think it is the way of contributing, I would like your inputs to make it a little bit more interactive. Because I can see the faces, you are almost like, yeah, conference is about to finish and we go roam around Singapore. Yeah.
So you can try out code and see the output instead of trying to understand how it produces that output.
Yeah, you don't need to go into the depth of the functionality, or you don't need to be an expert, you can read the code. Anybody else? Basically, answer is in front of you, so you can read the lines. So, it is the best way to learn the new things. If you are a programmer, you can do the automation testing. You can develop an automation framework for the testing. But even if you are not a programmer, you are a user, you can do a manual testing. I'll give a very simple example to you. If I give you a pen, for example, and I would say, how would you test it? What will be the test case for it? For a pen? Can anybody tell me?
Writing.
See, how many of you are testers who answered this so quickly? Not professional testers, except you. Okay? So, that is how. Testing is so easy to learn. The application, the operating system, or anything you would like to test, it should be worked as expected. So this is the primary test case you come up with for a pen. What else you can test for a pen? It should open, it should have a cap, and if it is a Tic Tac pen,
doesn't it have a cap?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. But for the professional tester, there should be some corner test cases, some negative test cases, blah blah blah, this and that, just to make the term complex. And just to show that, yes, we are doing something more. So, anybody of you can easily participate in testing. That is the crux of the thing. You can develop the test. example, I would like to take an example of Fedora. If you are using any product in Fedora or Fedora operating system and you find that something is not working, for example, whenever I change the background of my system, it starts playing in Fedora 19 and I just open a bug against it and that's how it got fixed. So the quality of the product has improved. Even if I am not a tester, this is a very trivial thing to do for me. And that is how everybody can contribute in improving the quality of the thing. See. And other thing you can do is, whenever there is a new release coming, just upgrade yourself. Just upgrade your systems. One person was here, I asked him, what are you using? Fedora. Very confidently. Okay. Which version? 16. Wow. 21 has released. So try to upgrade.
16 is
more
stable.
Yeah. That's true. But then you need to make the other version, the latest version, more stable. Why it is stable? Okay, can you tell me, Huzaifa, why it is more stable? Because there are plenty of users of it.
No, because people right? have been using it for a couple of years.
Couple of years? Why? Why couple of years usability of that particular version made it more stable? Because people have logged problems against it. Yeah. They found the issues against it. And developers have fixed those issues. That's why it is more stable. Okay? So there are generally these ways you can contribute towards testing. Now, what is the test harness? Can anybody tell me what is the test harness? Don't read the answers first. Yeah, maybe. So test harness is more fun than the manual test. For example, this guy got married, newly married, already married. So he must have that experience. Okay, he has completed all his work in a week. He's a tester. For example, just for example, he tested everything so nicely in that 1 week. And at the weekend, he went to his wife and told her that we'll go to a movie. I'll finish my work today very fast because there are all testing done and today we'll go to the movie. She's very excited as we girls have this feminine quality that even if the movie showtime is at 7 p.m. we'll start our makeup at 4 p.m. So she was all ready and just waiting for him to come down and ring the bell. This fellow went to the office, went to the manager cabin, okay, all testing is done, today I can leave in time. And then the surprise, new build has come. New build of the product or for the application which he needs to test again. So it means if the product is releasing, the application is releasing next day, he has to compile or execute all the test cases he has executed for the past 1 week. So if he go and do it manually, it means it's gonna take another 1 week and he cannot complete his work. And you can guess the reaction of his wife who is putting makeup for 2 hours.
Are you saying that if you are a tester, you can't take your wife out for a movie?
If you don't believe in test harness, then yes. So test harness is automation, developing test script using test automation tools. So it is very important, the things which can be automated, you should automate. So it is a step towards becoming a equivalent developer. A step towards. There are so many languages, open languages which you can use, like Python is there, which is very famous, which provides so many frameworks to use for testing. That is Python test is there, Nose is there. So all these things makes your life easy and you can take your wife to the movie. Happy. Right?
What if you don't know?
I don't know. I should ask this question to your wife. Okay. So for the developers, include testing in your development. How you can do that? Can someone give me the examples quickly? How a tester can focus on testing part also while developing things? Because I think you are a developer, tell me.
I do not.
that is one thing. You may do anybody else for a TV test. Okay. Anybody else? Can you tell that in little detail?
TDDA says it's test driven development. It says that you write your test first and the application code afterwards.
Yeah.
Which is an approach towards development.
Which nobody follows.
People follow. It's an approach. If you take that approach, then you follow that approach.
Yeah.
It depends how successful it is and how you include it in your product,
that's
in your project.
Right. We should do it. Right. We should do it. Kick off the testing along with the development phase.
Don't you think that development and testing should be independent of each other?
No.
They both should be driven out of the same requirement.
They should be collaborated, they should be integrated.
Yeah, I agree they should be integrated, but coding for some test cases is don't you think that is not the ideal?
Not coding for some test cases. You should code for the requirements.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
But you should follow some standards in order to avoid bugs.
Yeah, some standard test cases I can have which I would test immediately.
It is not just right. That is okay. That is one very good point to having test cases by the development team also. But that is not the only way to do it. There are other guidelines the developer should always follow to, you know, avoid the error prone code and lessen the burden of the tester also. So what are these things are? Try to use two languages. Object-oriented languages which have error handling, which have exception handling in it. So that at the first place only you have handled some failures already. Okay, you understand my point? And then you should avoid a bug-prone code. What is a bug-prone code? You understand that? No indentation, no proper spacing. It is not readable at all. Even if you can read the code, you want to troubleshoot where is the bug, you cannot do that. Because if you open the code, it's like a tree structure or some structure which developer may have liked at that time by typing that code. So that is the one thing. Other than that, include unit testing, which is very good point Alicia has put down, that test cases should be written along with your development. Some starting test cases. If you have tested that build, if you deliver that build without even unit testing, it may possible that it will crash or it will not get installed, the package is not getting installed itself. So these are some cases you can avoid. And then the most important thing is continuous integration. Along with the development, you should have the testing parallelly going on. Like, for any product release or application release, you have phases, alpha, beta, and the final release. So there should be a coordination between the development and between the testing team. This alpha is released, you should test this first. Now beta is released, this should be tested parallelly. If there are some bugs, get it fixed. Finally, you ship the final GA version and then you test it. So this is the continuous integration which can lead to a very quality product. Okay? So these are some things which are expected from developers to avoid bugs. Now, you may ask this question, if developers will test everything, what testers will do? So, obviously this cannot be the answer. There are many types of testing which a user and a developer may not be able to do. For example, we have white box, black box, and a gray box testing. How many of you know about what is black box testing? Yeah?
Should I answer the question or?
You want to answer the question?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Let's start with white box.
Yeah.
Black box testing is like looking at the code, reading the code, trying to understand. And black box testing is like a little bit the opposite. You just test the final product on the user interface, I would say. Something like that. You just click a unit with your mouse.
That's it. So the The white box testing is when you know the functionality, know the code internally, and you can troubleshoot very well. But the black box testing is that you don't know the details of the application. You just put the inputs, get the output, and you don't do the troubleshooting at all. Anybody know the gray box testing? Okay, so it is a mix of the white and black. That you know, you may know some of the functionality, but you don't know all the functionality of the application. Now, anybody know about the blue box?
Blue box?
Yeah. Neither do I. Okay. So,
who?
Other than that, we have tier 1, 2, 3 testing, which is also the job of the tester. I'm not going to give the details about it. This is just to tell you how important testers are, and even if there are people to cover the testing, these are the detailed testing which a tester have to cover. Acceptance, long duration, stress, reliability, this and that, and what not. Okay. This is another important job of the tester to find bugs in the application and the product. Little bit about the bug. If your application is not working as expected, so it is called a bug. But there is always a difference between an error, between a failure and a bug. You have to understand what is the problem here. Sometimes our environment, our setup is not proper. Sometimes our configuration is not proper. And then for each and everything you are doing, not working, go to the developer, not working. Try a small thing, not working. Go to the developer, not working. What you are doing? This is not the way. So you have to make sure that the problem you are reporting as a bug is a potential problem, but not the other things going wrong at your site. So there are very good bug tracking tools. For example, there is Bugzilla, which is used for Red Hat bug reporting tool as well, Fedora bug reporting tool as well, which provides. There are so many other bug reporting tools as well, and there are so many sections in that which you need to fill. Sometimes we go there, feel lazy. Okay, I am facing this issue. We should report. You go to the bug reporting tool and see how many fields you need to fill, and you say, I don't give a damn to, and I don't want to take the efforts to fill all those fields, so let it be. So that should not be the case, because I'll tell you why all those fields are important. A bug should have a description, a crash report if it is a crash bug, and everything else in the place, like in which build version you have worked on when you face the bug. This all information is important for the developer. He's thinking from the developer's perspective, who gonna fix that bug. He obviously needs all those information. So that is why it is important. And if you feel you are lazy, you can use the bug reporting tools. Like for example, ABRT, which is automated bug reporting tool. If you have encountered some crash or something like that, if you have configured that ABRT, it will go to the your bug tracking tool. It will put all the fields and plus the crash report in it for yourself. I don't think we have much time, so I'll just go through the slides quickly. Last thing is troubleshooting. So if a good tester always troubleshoot his problem, you remember I told you just 2 minutes back that there should be definitely a difference between an error, failure and configuration error and between a bug. So troubleshooting is really very important in the part of the tester. If you know more about your application, you should be able to troubleshoot it. And the best way to troubleshoot a problem is log. Look at the place, folder, where your logs are getting accumulated. Read it, and you will get to know where is the problem. Okay? Read your code and use the tools which will pin down the problem area, like Walgreens. At the end, I'm a tester, I will accept this thing that nothing is 100% bug free. But a good tester will make sure that the application will qualify, at least the requirements, and it is working fine. Okay? Thank you. Any questions?
Can you tell me your bank details so that I can transfer money to your
office? Oh, yes, sir. Any questions? Yes, sir.
You told us about your work of continuous integration.
What is that?
Continuous integration.
Yes,
clear. That is very important. So I wonder if it's also nice to have automated tests behind that stage.
Yeah.
So, because this like walks hand in
hand. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Actually, what happens is when you have first build of the product, you may not have the automated test cases for that. But for the same product, if you are having second build, third build, or even if the operating system is coming along, version 14, 16, 17, you obviously have tons of test cases which are already automated. So that is accepted testing. The moment the build comes, there are open source tools like Jenkins, where you can have your job configured in a way that build is coming, the moment build comes, even if the tester doesn't know about it, the acceptance test in place will get executed and give the report back.
Yeah. And you have like robot framework to integrate into Jenkins to the automatic test.
Yeah, exactly.
Some terms I'm kind of confused about in when I talk to about testers. They talk about smoke tests.
Yes.
Performance tests,
stress
testing, and regression testing.
Yeah, these are just fancy terms to make sure that the testers are important.
I appreciate your frankness, but
jokes apart. Definitely, these are the things which a tester need to do manually sometimes.
Okay.
But within, that's what I said, within the time, within the build progresses, we have few things getting accumulated in our automation framework.
Sure.
So that is it.
Okay.
Any other questions? If you have any questions, you can meet me outside. Or tonight I'm going to set up some. If you want to report, chase me there, you can come. Thank you, everyone.
Right.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.